Hey, how's it going, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today, we're talking about the Joe Pavelski incident and Cody Eakin, Game 7, huge game. But before I get into that, I just want to say thank you for watching the last couple of videos. We've done enormously well for my standards, and I appreciate it. If you want to share this video with people or share any of my videos with people, make sure you do, because I want to know more about what you guys think. A lot of you guys write some really good responses. Sorry, I'm burping. You guys write some really good responses, and they're really fun to read. And even if, you know, sometimes you guys are insulting my hockey IQ, I do appreciate the comments. It's a lot of fun to read you guys' comments and to have a conversation with you guys. I try to reply to as many things as I can. Some are pretty repetitive, you know, but you guys get the point. And well, let's take a look at this Joe Pavelski incident.
It's just a war zone down in front of Floyd. Down goes one of the Sharks, and staying down. Is that Pavelski?
Oh my, that's Pavelski, he's bleeding.
As Cody Eakin sits for now, but he might get a major penalty and could be out of this game.
And the draw, right there. He creates cross check, and then a double whammy as his head hits off the ice.
Okay, keep an eye on Pavelski. He falls, you're right, on the side of his head.
And Cody Eakin's out of the game.
Like, that tells you how much these guys care about each other. Thornton's right there holding the towel to the side of his head with Burns and King.
So as you can see, Cody Eakin cross-checks Joe Pavelski, but Joe Pavelski falls and he gets bleeding, and then Joe Pavelski is ultimately helped off the ice. He's injured. It doesn't look good. He looks like he might even have a concussion after the way his head hit the ice, which is horrible to see. You really don't want to see that stuff. Terrible. But was it a five-minute major worthy? Okay, well, let's look at it. Cody Eakin, off the draw, cross-checks Pavelski. It's clearly, you know, a penalty. Cody Eakin didn't need to cross-check him, but he cross-checked him. It's clearly a penalty. Sure. No doubt. Now let's go to the next step. Was it a four-minute penalty? How's it a four? How do you get a four for cross-checking? And I think the only time I've seen a four for cross-checking, or a four for anything, is slew-footing. And then if they're bleeding. But the problem is, how do you give a four for cross-checking? I mean, like, he's bleeding. I understand that. But he's bleeding from his own helmet. He's not bleeding from Cody Eakin. He's bleeding from his own helmet's crack or whatnot because the way that he landed on the side of his head. Was it a terrible play? Yes. Was it a terrible incident? Yes. Was it in malicious intent? No. Joe Pavelski, in my opinion, was falling backwards in the play. He got cross-checked, and he looked to be kind of surprised, so he leaned up, and he started to lose his footing. And then, hold on, we're not done here. Cody Eakin is done. He's not even a part of this play now. And as Pavelski falls, he gets hit again by another player. And I don't think he really hit him. He kind of ran into him. But unfortunately, it changed the directory of Pavelski, which ultimately led him to fall on his shoulder and hit his head on the ice, and that is why he got hurt, and now he was out. So that is the 4 minutes. Now we move ahead, and the referees say it's five. 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 Five in a Game 7 situation is you have to literally be super obvious, and you have to be a real dumb person to take a 5 in a Game 7, where your team could be out of the series and out of the season, and you could be golfing with Tiger Woods soon. 5. I watched it now for like the 13th time, and I completely, like, I'm trying to look at the little details that a lot of you guys have been pointing out in different videos, so I'm looking at those, and I'm looking at the little details, and I'm looking at his footing, and I'm looking at Pavelski and where he can hit. Cross-checks Pavelski, and where Pavelski gets hit on the second way down, on the way down, I meant to say, all of it, to me, looks like a freak accident, and that it shouldn't have been a 5. And why am I talking about this? Because it's just a 5, and it's just Cody Eakin, and also, it's just the Vegas Golden Knights. No, I'm just kidding. It's a 5 in Game 7, and it's crucial, because, obviously, if you haven't watched the replays, or the game itself, they went back, and they scored 4 goals, and 4... just over 4 minutes, I'd say, they scored 4 goals, and they took the lead, and then the Vegas Golden Knights had to fight back. They luckily scored, went to overtime, and then lost. And I guess you can argue, well, that annuls the whole power play. Yeah, but they would have been, you know, in, you know, or 3-0. They would have been up 3-0, or maybe even let one goal in only, and it would have been 3-1, and the Vegas Golden Knights still would have had a power play. Or sorry, the Vegas Golden Knights would have still had a lead 3-1. That's why I think it's important to remember that this power play really did change the game. This is one of the most game-changing power plays we've seen in this playoffs. Huge. Changed the entire course of the game for a very questionable call, in my opinion. I still don't think that it was enough to give a 5. It looked like a freak accident that occurred, and I think that the blood that drew from Pavelski really pushed that edge where it was like, okay, maybe we should just give a 5 because this is pretty, you know, nasty. It looks nasty, but was it really nasty? Because when we look at the replays, we have, you know, as viewers, we have the great benefit of the doubt to rewatch some great replays. And I tried to watch it in full motion as much as I could, not in slow motion, because that doesn't do justice to what happened. Although it gives us the great opportunity to see each play happen, like his footing, him losing his footing, you know, and the cross check, which is important to me, because if you want to argue that it was a four for blood, I don't know how you cross check somebody in the chest and he bleeds from the side of his head, and it's clearly from the contact on the ice. And it's really an unfortunate play, and I'm not blaming Pavelski for any of this. We really hope he's all right, and I just want to make sure that that's clear. I'm not attacking any San Jose player or anything like that. We really hope they're okay. But I don't think that Eakin should have been given 5 minutes in a game misconduct for this. It's really just absurd. It's crazy, crazy. A five. In game 7 in the playoffs. I mean, that's crazy. All right, well, I'm not going to ramble on too long. That's what I think of this. Let me know what you think of the